the question 2b from part b of EM waves and transmission lines for second BTech second semester April May 2009 previous paper J2K R16 regulation. This is the question from set 1. Derive the capacitance of a coaxial cable per unit length using Maxwell's equation. This question is given for 7 marks. Remember that here there is no use of Maxwell's equations actually. By mistake it is given in the question using Maxwell's equation, but no Maxwell's equation is required to derive this capacitance. First let us see what is coaxial cable is actually. The coaxial cable is actually consisting of a, see, the coaxial cable is actually consisting of a inner conductor. The coaxial cable is consisting of inner conductor. This is called an inner conductor of radius say A, of radius A, and it consisting of an outer conductor. It consists of an outer conductor of radius B. Assume that this is inner conductor, this is outer conductor, thus let epsilon is the dielectric medium between these two plates. Let us assume that the inner conductor is carrying a charge of plus Q, and outer conductor is carrying a charge of minus Q. Let us assume that L is the length of this coaxial cable. What is coaxial cable? It consists of inner conductor of radius A, outer conductor of radius B, and length L. Let the inner conductor, in between the inner conductor and outer conductor, a dielectric medium is filled with epsilon. So let us assume that this outer conductor is 2 and the inner conductor is 1. So this is the arrangement of coaxial cable. What we want to find out, since this is one conductor, this is outer conductor, since two conductors are separated by a dielectric material, so this arrangement is said to form a capacitance. That capacitance is called as coaxial capacitance. So therefore, what is the potential? The potential difference between this 1 and 2 is mathematically given as minus integral of 2 to 1 E dot dl. So this is the formula which I am going to use to derive the capacitance of coaxial cable. Why we have taken 2 to 1? Because always the electric field is from positive charge to negative charge. So therefore we are doing work against the electric field. That is why we have taken 2 to 1. Now we want to find out what is the electric field intensity in between these two conductors. Our question is, what is the electric field in between these two conductors? In order to find electric field, always it is remember that in order to find out the electric field between inner conductor and outer conductor, we have to take a Gaussian surface. Let us assume that this Gaussian surface is a cylinder. What is red line? Red line is a Gaussian surface. What is Gaussian surface in this case? The Gaussian surface in this case is a cylinder. Which encloses the inner conductor completely, plus Q charge completely. So we have to apply Gauss's law to this Gaussian surface. So therefore, applying, in order to find out E, so therefore remember that the Gaussian surface radius is always rho. So by applying Gauss's law to this Gaussian surface, Applying Gauss's law to the Gaussian surface, that is how much flux leaves this Gaussian surface, that is closed surface integration of D dot ds is equal to Q enclosed, that is how much flux leaves this Gaussian surface and how much charge is inside this Gaussian surface. Remember that for cylindrical Gaussian surface, the left hand side is always simple, d rho into surface area of the Gaussian surface. What is the surface area of Gaussian surface? 2 pi rho l. Since it is a cylinder, the surface area of Gaussian surface is 2 pi rho l, where d rho is the flux density in unit area at the Gaussian surface. So therefore, how much charge is inside this Gaussian effect? It encloses total charge Q. So therefore, d rho is taken as Q by 2 pi rho L. Since the flux density is always along the radial direction from the Gaussian surface, so therefore substitute this Q by 2 pi rho L into A rho. So this is D. So now what is electric field intensity? Electric field intensity, as you know, that is D by epsilon, from which E is equal to D by 2 pi epsilon rho L into A rho. So this is the electric field between what? Between the two cylinders. Between the two cylinders, this is the electric field intensity in the in between the two cylinders. Now substitute E in this formula. So therefore, substitute this E in this formula, the potential difference between the two cylinders. So that is equal to minus integral B to A. We are doing work against the electric field B to A. What is E? E is given by Q by 2 pi epsilon, 2 pi epsilon rho L A rho dot dot dl. What dl we have to take in cylindrical coordinate system? In cylindrical coordinate system we have to take d rho A rho. So therefore, in this equation you remember that A rho dot A rho is 1. So therefore, what is constant in this integration? Minus Q by 2 pi epsilon L is a constant. So therefore, what is the rest of the integral? Minus B to A d rho by rho. B to A d rho by rho. So which will come out? It has minus Q by 2 pi epsilon L. What is d by dx by x log rho? If you substitute the limits, log A minus log B. So it will come out log, natural logarithm log A, or in fact natural logarithm of log A minus log B. So if you multiply it by minus sign, Q by 2 pi epsilon L into log B minus L log A, which is written as log B by A. So this is the potential difference between the two cylinders. Now by definition of capacitance, what is the definition of capacitance? The capacitance is simply defined as magnitude of charge on one of the cylinders by potential difference applied between the two cylinders. So therefore, take this V this side and take this term right side. So it will come out 2 pi epsilon L by log B by A. So this is the capacitance. This is the capacitance between the two cylinders, capacitance of this coaxial cable. In fact, the capacitance of the cable, it is asked the capacitance per unit length. The capacitance per unit length, substitute L is equal to capital L is equal to 1 in this equation. So therefore, the capacitance C is equal to, if you substitute L, it will come out 2 pi epsilon by log B by. So this is the answer for this problem. This is the capacitance of coaxial cable per unit length. So this is the answer for this problem, which we have to prove.